Brothers and sisters, good morning to all, and warm welcome from our pastoral care for Philippine migrants. Let us join our hearts together in praise and thanksgiving to God. in the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. We are joined today by our mass sponsors, Santo Niño de Cebu Association of Ocamo, in this celebration. Let us also implore the prayers and intentions of family, Karabi and family, Jubilatory and family, Mari and Corales, Oiruma Sabana family, Pagalang family, Marisen Taverna family, Linda Sumano family, Polanay family, Labiano family, San Carlos family, Valenzona family, Jose Braga Uban, Ricolta Braga family, Inano family, Jima Makalahan, Linda Astrero family, for the birthday of John Cullen, Judy Dawson, John John, Maria Rose Dawson, for the healing of the sick, John Lloyd Villantes, Ligaya Traya, Mary Linda Neva, for the souls of our faithful department, Heroleto Tan, Mariano Bumboy, Saul, Chunita, Jose Rosalinda, Alfredo Erlinda, Feliciano Pacifico Bibica, Angel, Carlota, Hermines, Nina, Agustin, and Jerry, and for the souls and for the prayer. Let the shepherd come to me and do the tender name. Please all stand and join the choir in singing your entrance to me.
Joyfully begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we celebrate today the feast of the Santo Niño, we ask for his intercession. that all children may be taken care of, and that the Lord may bless them and as well as their parents, and our community in particular, here in Macau. Brothers and sisters, let us now bow our heads for a while, and we humbly acknowledge before our God all our prayers and our sins, for us to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Brothers and sisters, we quite contrite hearts, we pray, I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have been deceived in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my hope, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
No.
Let us pray. Almighty God, your only Son, begotten from all ages, humbled himself as a child in Nazareth, and became subject to Mary and Joseph. Grant that we may learn from his example to embrace your will in all things, and holding fast to the dignity of all. Serve our lowly servants and sisters, with open hands and gentle heart, we ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. In the first reading, the oracle we are about to hear is a prophecy about Jesus, the Messiah, who brings the light of God's love into the world darkened by sin.
A proclamation from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walk the darkness in the darkness have seen a bright light. Upon those who dwell in the land of gloom, light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the fool and on their shoulder, under rod of the taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every club rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, Father Forever, God Heru. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. He will rule as David's successor, basing his power on right and justice. From now until the end of time, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. True word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please sponsor your song. Let our response be, the Lord is with me, let the many hours be glad.
His right hand has won victory for him. He's a holy one.
The Lord is king, let the nations be glad. The Lord is king, let the nations be glad.
The Lord has salvation known in the rock. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
The Lord is King.
Salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord. All your head, all of us, break into song.
The Lord is King.
With a harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
People were bringing their little children to Jesus, that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced the children and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the moment.
Brothers and sisters, first of all, magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat. May I please invite you to greet the person next to you. Good morning. Good morning. And as we celebrate the Feast of the Santo Niño, we greet each other. Viva Santo Niño! Viva Santo Niño! Amen. Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. Brothers and sisters, today is a special day for the Filipino community here in Macau as we celebrate this Feast of the Santo Niño. As you can see here at the altar, there are non-celebrating priests. So in behalf of the Pastoral Care for Filipino Migrants and in behalf of all the priests, we are one in celebrating and offering this Mass for our community. Let me introduce from left, Professor at the USJ University of St. Joseph, Faculty of British Studies and Philosophy, from the Society of Jesus. He loves the Filipino community here in Macau. He was and he is always with our celebration. So we welcome Father Felipe Bacarso SK. And of course, he was a former parish priest in the Archdiocese of Cebu before he came here, so he knows really in heart and mind the spirit of the celebration of the Santo Niño. Next to him is also a professor at the USJ Faculty of British Studies and Philosophy from the Opus Dei, and our regular celebrants of our Mass during Sundays, we welcome Father Joey Mandia. And next to him at my back is our assistant chaplain of the Pastoral Care for Filipino Migrants, and as well as the parochial vicar of the Cathedral Parish of the Diocese of Macau, a member of the Redemptoris Mater, our very own Reverend Father Sheldon D'Souza. And next is a Clavician priest who serves the Diocese of Macau and before many years in Japan and other places. And he loves to serve in spite of his old age at 85 years old. He always hears confessions, not only for the Filipinas, but for all other communities as well here in Macau. He is from Italy, a Clarician priest, retired but not tired, Father Mario. And also, on behalf of the Philippine General Consulate in Macau, we are one in celebrating the Feast of the Santo Niño for this year, 2024. Malapakan po namin sa mga. Brothers and sisters, the celebration of the Feast of the Santo Niño is very important to the life of the Filipinas. Why? Because the celebration of the Santo Niño is part of the history of the Philippines. We cannot escape that fact that the Santo Niño is part of the Philippine history. In March 16, 1521, Magellan bought the image of the Santo Niño from their long journey from Portugal to the Philippines. It is the first symbol of Christianity in the Philippines. Before we know the cross, the crucifix, we are already introduced with the image of the Santo Niño in the Philippines more than 500 years ago. If we're going to look at it, well, Magellan and his companions traveled from Portugal, from Europe to the Philippines, with Santo Niño on their side. They traveled with the Santo Niño. It is a good image of, they have a traveling companion, and that is the Santo Niño. If we are going to ask ourselves, who is our travel companion in our life, from the Philippines to Macau, who is our traveling companion? Or shall we say, who is our coach, life coach in life? Please ask the person next to you, sino ang coach mo sa buhay? Who is your coach in your life? Who is your traveling companion? Brothers and sisters, please be reminded that if we take the Santo Niño, if we take Jesus as the traveling companion along the way, of course, we will be blessed, we will be secured, we will experience safety. Jesus as a coach of life, hindi tayo dadali sa dilim, hindi tayo aakayin sa dilim, kasalanan kung hindi sa kaluan natin. When Jesus is our coach, hindi tayo tuturuan ng masama. God will not teach us something bad, but rather teach us how to be a good person, how to be a good Christian, how to be a good Catholic. So please have Jesus to be our companion in our life. Amen. And it says it's a symbol of Christianity. Why? Because the Santo Niño was the gift of Magellan when the first converts, the leaders of the community, Ara Humanyo, the wife of Raja Humanyo, was baptized and named Juana, and Rara Pumabon was named Carlos. So you can see, the first Christians in the Philippines, they received that gift of Santo Niño from Magellan, and was given, it's as a symbolic gift at the beginning of Christianity in the Philippines. That is why we love the Santo Niño. Amen? Besides, little child, mamaliging na bata, ay malapit sa puso natin. Amen po? Sorry for Father Mario and Father Sheldon, I'm mixing Tagalog in English. No? So, mga bata, I love children. During the mass, whenever I see a children, I wave to them, hello, what's your name? How old are you? You know, one time, I was very happy because I love to bless children, you know. There's a couple, and then having a stroller, and I'm very happy that, wow, that there is this this little boy that I can greet for that day. So I was very excited, you know. So I go direct, and I said to the parents, good morning, how are you going to the church? Yes, Father, yes, Father. And immediately, with my excitement, okay, how's the baby? Hello, baby! When I look, the one in the strollers look at me, ow, 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 ow. It's a dog. It's a puppy. It's good that I was not beaten. Opo, ganyan na po ngayon ang uso yata, no? No? Kinagawa na natin baby ang mga yan. There's a survey in the United States, sorry to say this, I don't know how true, subject for confirmation. They love to have dogs rather than to have children. Pets. So, yes, in our gospel reading, they are trying to prevent children to come to Jesus. Sinasaway nila yung mga bata. And in our translation from the Gospel of St. Mark, Jesus rebuked the disciples. He became indignant. But nagalit si Jesus when they prevent children. So why is that practice of preventing children? Last December 28, we celebrated the Feast of the Niños. So we pray for those children who have died during the reign of King Herod. When all children, boys, 2 years old and below, were killed. Why? Because there was a prophecy. A child, a baby boy, is to be born. And that little child is the hope of Israel. He will reign in Israel. It did not mention where that baby boy would come. So, in Herod, he did not know where. So to be safe, even his own 3 sons he killed, because he doesn't want to have another king in our lives. He wanted to be the only king, you know. Sometimes we have this, you know, tendency to become king Herod. We want to be the king of the world. But that little, that baby, the child, later was given a name. In our first reading, it was given a name, Wonder Counselor, God Heroes, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. You see? And then later on, the story, born from the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Jesus became the King and hope of Israel. So with that, ang sakit para kay Herod, nang papalit sa kanya ay isang bata. Ang mga bata ng panahon ngayon are not counted. They have no numbers. When Jesus feed the 5,000, it says 5,000 men, excluding women and children. So sorry po sa mga babae na nandito sa kultura ng mga hugil, wala kayong bigla, kamila. Kami lang mga lalaki na may bigla kayo. Sorry po. At kami ngayon naman po, ganun. Kaya makita niyo, manggagaling ang hari saan? Sa walang bigla. Hindi kasama sa bigla. So parang sa palulo na kayo mahirap. So, sa kanila, baka. Baka lang. Pero kay Jesus iba, let children come to me. Sabi niya. And do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as this. I know that you have your children. Okay? So, may I please know, sino po may anak? 12 years old and below. Sa? Sino may anak na 12 years old and above? Nandang, very good. Kumusta po kayo? Kumusta mga bata nyo, mga anak ninyo? I would like to share this because I would like to inspire your brothers and sisters. But despite that we are here in Macau, far away from your families, you can still be a hands-on parent. Sometimes there is a tendency na ma-focus na tayo po sa paghahanap ng ikabubuhay. We focus on our work. Basta makapagpapadala tayo para okay na ang buhay. Para masaya na tayo. Para nagkakaroon ng value ang buhay natin kapag nagpapadala tayo. Kaya kung isa nangihinayang na tayo magpakasyon, sayang ang ating tikitan. Pag-uwi natin sa Pilipinas, sometimes, normally 15 days ang vacation natin. Sino nakakapiling natin? Marami ang nakikita. Attend ng elementary school reunion, high school reunion, college reunion, family reunion, outing. Pag nag-outing naman, hindi naman kasama yung pamilya niya, kasama nga, pero kasama si Nipag, si Vianan, si... So, dahil ikaw ang boss, ikaw ang nag-iaya, kasukasuhin mo sila. And a lot of time is eaten, nakain na yung time mo para mapagpating sa mga. First of all, brothers and sisters, pag-uwi niyo po, magbabakasyon kayo. Magbakasyon kayo, mag-outing kayo, sarili nilang pamilya. Walang ibang kasama. Iba yun. Kasi ang tagal nun na wala. Maximize your time with your family. Mahirap po yung dumating sa kung tumahan na mahan yung pamilya mo. Pag-uwi mo doon, ang pakiramdam mo, nandun ka, wala ka, parehas mo. Hirap mo, ako yun. Diba? Nagpapakahirap ka dito, pag-uwi mo, gusto mo yung close tayo. Pero pagdating mo doon, parang okay lang. Hirap. So, establish connection with them while you are here. Kung may anak kayo mag-aaral sa elementary, mag-video call kayo, anak, pakipicturan mo nga yung assignment mo, isend mo sa akin. Tutulungan kita. Mag-aaral tayo ng dalawa. Kahit malayo pa, your children would feel just parang nasa tabi ka lang nila. May kasama silang nag-aaral. Dati sila, pohon na trabaho, pero kasama mo sila. How many of you have done that? Mas gustuhin na natin magpahinga, matulog. But we are working because we want to build families, not just provide food for them. Diba? Gawin niyo po yun. Another thing, dito, si Jesus sabi niya, hayaan niyong lumapit sa akin ng mga bata. Let us pause for a while. Let children come to me. Nailalapit kaya natin ang ating mga anak kay Jesus? Do we find ways na mailapit namin sila? There is one OFW that I admire. Ngayon na siya sa Pilipinas. Asawa niya at anak niya nandun. Pero every Sunday, sa Saturday pa lang, sabi niya, mga anak, gaya ko na ikamit yung buka, sisimba kayo, ha? Saka yung asawa niya, sabi, papa, mga anak, siguraduhin mo, ha? Saka ikaw, magsisimba ka, ha? Tapos na lang ng asawa niya, pag hindi sila nagsimba, walang padala. Sorry siya. Diba, siyempre. Palibawa ko, 11 na kulang ako isa. Sabay-sabay sila, nagmimisa yung anak pamilya sa Pilipinas, nagmimisa sa dito sa Macau. Pagkatapos ng misa, siyempre, may allowance kahit sa labas. Kahit din siya sa labas, kahit nag-iisa. Kahit nag-iisa, mas dahil siya, kasama niya kumakain, pabidyo. Sa Pilipinas. Diba? Para wala ka doon, na parang nandun ka. Kaya, pag-uwi mo, OFW na ngayon. You can imagine how happy would they be. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Kaya, kayo, di ba? Masaya kayo pag nakikita niyo yung mga anak ninyo. Amen?
Amen.
Nasa kamay, masaya ka pag nakikita ang anak. Those who are happy, rejoicing when they see their children. Lahalos lahat ng raise your hands. Kung kayo masaya ka pag nakikita niyo ang mister ninyo. Isa, dalawa, tatlo. Teka muna. Why? What is that, brothers and sisters? Ba't di kayo masaya? Kung hindi po kayo masaya, makipag-appointment kayo kay Father, mag-counseling. Father, ilang masaya ka sa'yo. Harap lang, harap ko na lang, walang support sa family. Harap ko na lang yung nag-iisip na maganda sa family. I remember a little story. There was a young boy walking 20 minutes from his house to the school. Meron po siyang konting disabilities. Yung kanyang kamay hindi masyado nakapagdip. Hindi nga, hindi pa nga. Kaya nga yung papilapis niya medyo kuminsan nalalaglag. At yung kanyang pa, medyo mahina yung left foot niya. But anyway, napaka-diligent po niya. Gusto niya mag-aral, gusto niya makatapos. Kahit man lang signal high, ano po. So, at alam po, nasa top 10 siya. Binubuli siya, pinatawanan siya. Pero at least panlaban niya, kung ako top 10, may kabuli-buli ka sa pa. Yeah. Anyway, grade 11 na siya. One more year, he will be finishing his signal high. And then yung po nangyari, one week hindi na siya pumasok. One week hindi siya pumasok. Nag-worry yung kanyang mga teachers and yung mga friends niya sa school. And then few officers of his class and the teacher, binisita siya sa bahay. And there, nakita siya. The first question ng teacher, bakit hindi ka na pumapasok? Sabi niya, teacher, I don't want to go to school anymore. So what happened? Sabi niya, because, sabi ng parents ko po, huwag na lang ako mag-aaral kasi sayang lang. It's a waste of time. Pag nakagraduate daw po ako, wala na magkatanggap sa akin. Mahina ang kanang kamay, mahina ang kaliwa pa. Sabi ko sa akin, dito na lang ako sa bahay. Tumulang na lang akong magtinis ng bahay, magluto, maglaba, para daw po may nakutusan sila. And the little boy summarizes everything. Sabi niya, ayaw ko na po mag-aaral kasi wala naman po akong nakukuha ang suporta sa pamilya. I didn't get any support from my family. Brothers and sisters, we are family of God. All supports nandiyan. Ang hirap kapag kayo na lang nagdadasal sa pamilya ninyo. Kayo na lang nangangarap. Gusto ninyo, masabong-sabong lang, palibot-libot lang, patapay-tambay lang. Anak ninyo gusto niyo makatapos, siya naman hindi marunong. Wala sa kanya, ayaw niya makatapos. Wala sa kanyang pag-aaral. Basta may bagong sapatos palagi, si Katya School, gabing po. Hindi naman niya pangarap makatapos ang pag-aaral. Malungkot. Hindi niya iniisip makatapos ang pangarap niya makapapag-grow. Minsan na lang, bubis natin ang buhay para makatapos sila ng pag-aaral. Pero nung few years, mayroong sorry, tinanong mo grade 4, paglakumano gusto mo, they're expected to become a teacher, lawyer, police, etc. etc. But majority of them, ang sagot, gusto ko makapag-aaral. Does it speak of who we are? As a Filipino community celebrating today, brothers and sisters, it is part of life. Bahagi ng buhay natin. The message is, huwag nating hayaan that because of these realities, bagsak na tayo. Kailangan na. Kaya kami, may Santo Niño, there is hope. God, Counselor, Prince of Peace. Kung hindi mapayapa ang buhay mo, eto, brothers and sisters, eto yung Prince of Peace who will give you peace. If your life, simple, shall we say, here is God, offering His forgiveness. So brothers and sisters, this celebration, somehow, is not only for children, but for all of us. Come to me. Let children come to me. And the Lord will do the rest. Amen?
Amen.
So in this celebration, let us open our hearts and minds like a little children, humble, obedient, willing to wait, not easily to get mad, easy to forgive. All those qualities, I have no time. I just would like to talk about that. But there are other days and days, but for now, it is good. Let there's an invitation that children come to meet the Lord. Ilapit natin mga anak natin sa Panginoon. Amen? Huwag yung kung ano-ano po tinuturo ninyo. Minsan, kung mag-bless ako ng bahay, very good, very good. Sabi niya, anak, ano nga kay Father, pinagmamalaki. Father, marunong na mag-sign of the cross. Sige na, in the name of the Father, of the Son. Marunong na. Yung iba na namamali, in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Namamali. Pero happy ako doon, maliit pa na, tinuturoan naman ko siya. Pray, pray. Eh, yung iba nang tinuturo, imbis na tumamag na siya. Sorry sa sasabihin. Anong problema na dati? Nadinig niyo ba yun? Alam niyo? Anak, ano yung problema ni daddy? Hindi ko na yung monster na. Kasi, anong tinuturo? Turuan niyo muna si Kamag Nasal. Amen. Ilapit ko sila sa Panginoon. Amen. But the question is, kung yung magulang hindi lumalapit sa Diyos, paano niya mailalapit yung anak niya? So, yung paanyaya na let children come to me, para sabihin sa atin yun. Gusto niyo ba magkaroon ng post, pre-service, balabayan? Let Jesus be the post of our life. Let Jesus especially ask my guys, let Jesus become our traveling companion. Amen?
Amen.
We offer to the Lord our faith as we profess, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages,
God from God,
light from light, true God from true God,
begotten
and made,
the substantial
of the Father, through him all things were made,
for us men and
for us the salvation, he came down from heaven,
and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate
of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake,
he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and is seated on the heaven of heaven.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the Giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
As we honor the Santo Niño and are reminded of Jesus' special love for the young, let us turn our attention to our children and youth and pray for all their needs, and let our response be, Lord, graciously hear us. Please repeat,
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the whole church and heavenlies, may they evermore show appreciation for children and the youth, and thereby become an inspiration to the whole world. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the children yet unborn, may they be accepted by their parents as precious gifts and sign of trust from the Creator. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all children throughout the world, may they be loved, tenderly respected, and look upon us the hope of a better humanity. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the youth of our nation, may they grow in dedication, honesty, and purity, treasuring and appreciating authentic Filipino values. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all Catholic parents, may they care of their children as Mary and Joseph cared for Jesus and form them as upright citizens and zealous members of the Church. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the devotees of the Santo Niño, may their great devotion to the infant Jesus be a continuous inspiration for them to grow in love of God and neighbor. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the Holy Spirit may help us to recognize the gift of different charism within the Christian community and to discover the richness of different traditions and rituals in the Catholic Church. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
In silence, we pray for our personal intentions. Almighty and loving Father, we ask you to grant all our prayers and petitions we offer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the Holy Eucharist.
Thank you.
the sacrifice and yours will become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your thanks for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his soldiers.
God, our Creator, we offer the gifts of bread and wine to recall the childhood of your only Son. Let our offering be found the sacrifice of him who brought forgiveness and peace to the world. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Give up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give the thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for the peace of this all-filled mystery, true invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in our hearts, and begotten before all ages. He has begun to exist in time, so that pleasing up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation, and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Please tell us that.
Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter the room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Bago po tayo tuloy ang matapos ng pagdiriwang, ang konting pasasalamat po in behalf of the Santo Niño de Cebu Association in Macau, with their officers and members led by Sister Yoli, Duran, and fellow officers. We would like to thank all those who have become a part of the 9-day novena, for all the religious organizations, pastoral ministries, civic organizations. We thank all those who join us in the novena prayer in honor of the Santo Niño. For all those donors who have helped us make this possible with the logistics, thank you very much. And with all the priests I have introduced before the homily, and with all the support of the Philippine General Consulate in Macau, with our Consul General, Honorable Porfirio Mario Jr. Kung meron na po nakalimutan, hindi ko po sinasadya. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Palapakan po natin sa inyo. And our raffle will be held next Saturday, January 27, at the Pastoral Center. So please go there and join us in this extended celebration of the Santo Niño. Today's program, pagkatapos po ng final blessing, kami po mga pari ay mag-i-exceed. Papunta po kami doon sa doors, pintuhan. At habang umaawit po tayo ng awit sa Santo Niño, ay ang lahat po ng lalabas ay bebesan po yung kanilang ibig sa mamaya po paglabas ng pakitaas nila po. Para po, ito po yung ibig na nandito sa dito sa loob, sa altar. Siya po yung pinakahon yung lalabas. At paglabas po niya, let us continue with our Sinodon Festival Night Dancing dito lang po sa hanap. No? So, ayun po. And then, ang imahe po ay dadala po sa Sintra, and then afterwards, then the part 2 of the celebration, yung prong procession, doon na po maganda na. And then, let us stay well for the day. So we thank the Santo Niño de Cebu Association of Macau for hosting this year's event, Santo Niño Festival. Maraming salamat po. Palapakan po natin. Let us pray. Loving Father, you have nourished us at the banquet in honor of the child born of the Virgin. We pray that we may advance in wisdom and grow daily in faith and grace of love, so that we may find favor in your sight. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For orderliness, so first of all, we sing our decision and leave. So all priests will exceed and stay on the altar. And with the holy water, lalabas po tayo naman sa isang biblisan.
Saan sa man po pala
niyo? Paglabas natin, ito may lalabas na ito. So, and then habang nasa labas tayo, nabalinig tayo music, and then umidance while we wait for these evenings inside. Rather in front of the church. So,
Senor Santo Niño?
Ha? Okay. Ang pagkuha po ng picture, please,
Senor Santo Niño,
sa pintuan, kasi lalabas tayo tayo. Para maayos po, pag-isip tayo, maraming po sa Lord. The Lord be with you, with the fellow priests here, please. Let us give our blessing to God's people. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God enable you to appreciate the importance of our children and youth.
for the life of the church and society.
Amen.
May he make you his privileged instruments in promoting the welfare and growth of the children and youth of our country.
Amen.
May he reward your efforts with eternal life.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon.
Thank you. mi Señor, mi Señor, viva mi Señor, mi Señor, viva mi Señor. Oye, Dalina, Dalina. Oye.
Excuse me, patayin mo muna si ninyo, please. Itayo, itayo.